Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Shh, please, shush. We're going to go where we're in downtown Broken Hills and about to go into uptown Broken Hills. Okay, so now we're residential area. Interesting. Looks like we can go out this way. Oh, there's something there. A fuzzy painting. Before I do anything, let's look in here. A cover. And a toilet. Sharpened edges around the seat make this a very uncomfortable place to sit. Okay. So, not gonna go down there just yet. Just keep in mind that it's there. Nobody in this area, huh? A stove. Functional wood-burning stove. Okay, we've got Nuka-Cola and a lighter. Done. Let's see if this guy's friendly. A greasy, sweating ghoul. Come in already. Close the door behind you. Don't let in all the flies. Let in all the damn flies I want, loser. Alright, no need to shout. Sorry, I'm just a little on edge. All these damn flies and no air conditioning. If I had a little more power, I'd be able to shake them. But I don't. Who are you? I'm Eric. I used to run the hotel in town, but I had to sell it because of my fly problem. I also ran the tavern, but had to get out of that too, for the same reason. Finally, I used to run the generator, but flies kept getting into it. That's an awful lot of jobs. I have more questions. Yes? Where'd the flies come from? They come here because for some odd reason I exude fly nutrients. My body is rich with food for them, and this sweating just makes it worse. I'll be doing a favor by killing you. That's just plain nasty. Why not take a bath or something? I've tried that. I've tried everything. The only thing that keeps the flies off me is not to sweat. And when I don't have enough power to keep cool, I can't. Seriously? Fly nutrients. Have you tried bathing? Yeah, I asked that already. Where's the power generator? There's a power generating system downtown that controls the power of the city. If you could just go there and get permission to give me a little more energy for my air conditioning, I'd be grateful. Okay, I know where that is. How grateful. Cash or equipment? I could scrape a little something together for you if you did it. Can't promise much, but then it's not too huge a favor either. You've got a deal. Just make sure to have something for me when I get the power for you. I can't tell you how grateful I am to you. Please let me know as soon as you're done so I can turn up the air conditioning and take a bath. Will do. All right. A very uncomfortable looking sitting device, sometimes known as a couch. All right, so we have a quest. I know where that is. In here. Oh, a mutant. Have you heard that the humans are plotting to kill us? Well, he's not telling me to leave, so... I guess they don't all get along. There's a stove there. empty. Why don't we send old Bone Nose out to scout the area? Bone Nose? Is that Sulik talking? That's a window there? Oh. I'm moving. Oh, got out that way anyway. Alright. I got a little wisdom I can impart, but I don't feel like it. I wish we had some more light bulbs. Female townsperson. Some of my best friends are mutants and ghouls. Does anyone have a diaper? A diaper? He's gonna block me. You blocking me! The spirits be moving us. What was I saying? Is this a structure we can enter? Yes. I can't believe that son of a bitch. You call a son of a bitch, you son of a bitch. Alright, we have not gone in here. She wishes she had light bulbs too. Good thing playing D&D all those years told me a few things about courage. D&D. Who's talking about Dungeons & Dragons? Is that Sulik talking? Or his grandpa, whatever? Grandpa Bone? An old mutant. Wish we were more accepted by the humans. We're human in our own way. Got lockers here. Nice. Leather jacket. And more rubber boots. I'll take them. Anything else in here? We got chairs? Bunch of chairs. Oh, these are showers. Alright. Nice, all these unoccupied areas with lockers in them. Empty. Empty. Is there another one? Nope, wait, wait. Nope, alright. The desk has a fruit. Alright, I'll take that. What is it? Who is that? Oh, it's Sulik. There was someone in here with me about to kill me because I just grabbed all this stuff. Empty, what's this? A table. Nothing there. The stove. Alright. Well, it's been my pleasure, big guy. Some stuff we can sell. Oh, there's a click in there. Should I be afraid of that? Oh, what's going on over here? A bemused man in a lab coat. What is it you want? Out with it. I'm a busy man. Who are you? What's with the scorpion? I am the professor. What I do is applied intelligence testing. I create chemical compounds to increase intelligence. I'm trying some out on this Radscorpion here, after my failure with the plant.
You tried it out on a plant?
Of course I tried it out on a plant. I'm trying to increase intelligence from the ground up.
I see. Have you made anything that works?
Yes, I have. Thank you very much. You ever hear of Mentats? I helped develop a method for easy mass production of that drug, and others. Lots of others.
Really? Alright. Say, I'd like to try out my skills against your Scorpion.
You wish to take a test, eh? Do you wish to test your manual dexterity, your perception, or your intelligence?
How about my smarts?
You and the Scorpion will be playing a game of my own devising. I call it chess.
What? A game of your own devising? You call it chess. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
We've got some kind of minigame here?
Wait, I'm playing chess? Checkmate. What? You cheated. Don't be a sore loser.
Wait, I lost against a Radscorpion?
Hold up. I'd like to test my agility.
Very well, I'll be matching you against a Scorpion. You will both attempt to unlock those boxes. Good luck. I was gonna beat me here. My
lockpicking is at 60%. Woohoo! Beat that, Mr. Exoskeleton.
Click clock.
Click clack. How the hell did you pick a lock with claws?
Chitter.
Well, that was a tie.
Wait, I gained 500 experience from doing that. You were just as agile as the Radscorpion.
He's involved in a madcap scheme.
Yeah, he sure is.
Let's test my eyes.
Right. You'll stand behind this rail, and you and the Scorpion will tell me the letters you read from top to bottom, left to right.
How is the Scorpion gonna tell you?
God, let's go.
Okay, letters? Yes, that's correct.
Chitter, chitter, click, clack, chirp. Tail swing.
Correct. Good boy. Good boy. Your Morse code skills are improving nicely.
I gained 500 experience here, too.
Can I keep gaining experience?
Agility.
Do I lose experience if I lose?
I didn't get it.
Damn it. Damn it. You lose. Scorpion 4, Andrea King 2.
The eyes.
I guess this is a perception check? I'm not sure.
Well, I didn't win anything that time. Let's see if I can get any more points.
He always wins, doesn't he? Or he always gets it.
Why the hell are we here?
That was a tie.
Yeah, I didn't win anything. Alright. How about one more intelligence?
I could get another 500 points, maybe.
Checkmate.
One more time for chess.
I can't believe we're playing chess with a Radscorpion.
Yeah, it's getting me every time.
Okay.
Yeah, alright. What is this? A holo generator. A large-scale THT entertainment tape player. No new movies have been made in 80 years. For science. Failed to learn anything. Failing to learn stuff. Yeah, I need to get some of my skills up higher. Alright, well that was interesting. Never thought I'd be playing chess against a Radscorpion. Now have I gone in here? Doors closed, or probably not. See a worried man. We're gonna get a quest, aren't we? Who are you? What are you doing in my house? I'm here to rob you. I'm Andrea King. Great, great. Pleased to meet you. Looks distracted. Hey, look. You're an adventuring type, right? Yes. The reason I ask, you see, is because my wife is missing. I don't know where she is. She's been gone for days. I've asked around town and no one has seen her. Can you find her for me? I'll look around. What's she look like? She's blonde, sexy, and has the most incredible singing voice. I last saw her walking around this area. She didn't like mutants or ghouls, so she wouldn't have been near any of them. Nobody knows where she went. It's like she just disappeared. That should be enough. Alright, before that, I'll see if I can actually rob you. Come on, you're scared of a plant? Alright, another Nuka-Cola. Oh wait, no. Oh my god. Pack of cigarettes. Not taking anything in front of him. I thought that was on the other side. Alright. Looking for someone sexy. No one in here? Ooh, look at that. Brass knuckles. And 10mm jacket at hollow point. Nice. And nothing there. Alright, still looking around the residential area. Locked. Using the technique you learned from Max, you carefully undo the trigger mechanism and effortlessly lockpick the door. Oh, this is Chad's area? Chad's home? You open the dresser and find rows of files and notes. As you search through the records in the dresser, you notice a thin leather briefcase stuffed carefully deep in the back. Wow, it really looks like Chad was skimming money. Apparently he is preparing to skip town as well. Better tell Marcus all this. Alright. A briefcase with a Made in the USA label. Leather, good condition, but the combination lock is broken. Anything else we can find in here? Okay, so got some dynamite and a first aid book. Nice. Oh, that's a flare, not... It's not dynamite, it's flare. There's a chest here. Cool, some stim packs. Nice. Making out here. Alright. Tempted to get the hell out of here and do that, but... I got nothing to say to no one. Alright, we've got like a couple buildings left. There's this... You ain't from Vault City, are you? I don't know who they're talking to. We've got this... in that other area. A plow. Designed to be dragged by a Brahmin. Okay, this is much better than being in some cozy whorehouse. Boss Sulik's glaring at me again. Nothing much in here, just a plow. Yes, I'm a talking plant. Get over it and talk to me. What? You see a spare plant. And a plow. Is it 4 o'clock yet? I want dinner. Okay, he gave... Is this the one the doctor experimented on? Hi, nice weather we've been having, huh? Are you connected with that scientist in any way? Oh yes, the professor. He grew me from a tiny spore and nurtured me. But I realized from an early age that if I were to act as smart as I truly am, he'd cut me into pieces to examine me. So I played dumb and got planted out here. It's nice, but I'd like to branch out a little. You know, maybe get planted somewhere else. Branch out, indeed. So does he still have the scorpion? That thing is a mean chess player. It has a lot of bark and plenty of bite, if you know what I mean. But I know how to beat him. If you do me a favor, I'll tell you how. Really? How? My fine friend, if you will replant me near the ghoul's home over there, I will be happy to impart my deep-rooted knowledge of chess. It's a deal. Delightful. I'm very, very pleased. Just find yourself a shovel and come on back. When you're done, maybe I can tell you a secret. My friend, I do hope you continue to flower. It just so happens I have a shovel right here. Let's go. I'm so excited, I could release a spore cloud all over myself. Let's go. Ooh, the soil here feels so... different. Cleaner somehow. Probably because I don't have to share it with those other plants. Ah. Oh, yes. If you ever run across the professor and his scorpion, remember this chess maneuver. It's called the flying liver attack, and the scorpion cannot stand against it. Okay, I'm glad they just brought me here because I didn't know what... where he meant. Thanks, I'll try that out. Bye. Ah, my friend, you have returned. This is quite a delightful place here. The shade is perfect, and the company is simply dazzling. That Typhon, what a killer. He really makes my intellectual sap flow. Typhon, sounds familiar. What was that you mentioned about chess? Well, it was about how to beat the Professor's Scorpion at chess. My friend, it is simplicity itself. The flying liver attack is like a flytrap to that bug. It walks right into it, and then it can't extricate itself. I guarantee your success. I appreciate the information. Bye. Okay, so evidently I've never been in here. So tired of waiting. Tired of waiting for you. Wish we had some plants around. You have one around. What was I saying? A withered old ghoul. Ghouls these days. Bah. You like muties? I like muties. These guys talk a lot. I wonder why it wants to be over here. I wonder if this has some other motive. I wonder how old Jed is up in Gecko. Howdy there, kiddo, and welcome to the old ghoul's home. Old ghoul's home? It's kind of a joke. There ain't any old ghouls but old ghouls. We're all sterile, you see, but we're incredibly long-lived. We're the first and last generation of ghouls. This is a place for those of us who just want to rest for a while. I see. I had other questions. Like what? You ever heard of a geck? Yep, used to have some, but all the pure strain humans stole them to make their own little Gardens of Eden. Vault City might be your best bet to find one, either there or NCR to the south. Damn. Who are you? I'm Typhon. You ever hear of Set? He used to run the old-time town of Necropolis. Yes, from Fallout 1. I'm his son. Got born before the radiation hit us, so I grew up mutated. Ain't never been any other way for me. Tell me about Set. Total bastard would be a fine way to describe the old man. Being turned into a ghoul from the radiation didn't do much for his sense of humor or his sense of authority. Let me tell you, of course it kind of screwed up everyone's brains. I think growing up ghouly made it a little easier on me. Anything else you can tell me? Back in my running days, I won quite a few races, made quite a bit of cash. A long time ago, I stashed all of my winnings not too far from here. If someone was to do me a favor or two, I might tell them where that treasure is. What kind of treasure? What kind of treasure? Money, kid. Lots and lots of money. Enough to satisfy any sane person. What's the catch? Kid, you gotta do me a favor first. What is it? I'm an old guy, and I don't get out too much. Ain't got much chance for action, you know what I mean? So what I want is a cat's paw magazine. Find me one. That's easy. Here you go. Give the cat's paw to Typhon. Thanks for the mag, kid. Let me get back to you in an hour or so. Okay. In an hour or so. I ain't done yet, kid. Sheesh. Can an old ghoul have his privacy? I like potatoes. I like them mashed. I like them fried. Alright, playing, it's doing much for my morale. Is that Myron? He kept complaining in red? Get that magazine stirred up the old juices, and I figure that, for the sort of treasure I'm talking, you can hunt me down a few more things. Go get me a blow-up doll. You can probably find one in New Reno. Oh, God. Blow-up doll. Jeez, we had a deal, man. Damn it. I remember the glowing ones on the Necropolis. Those were the days. Alright. Have I been everywhere, then? I think so. Except down in there. Where am I? Am I stuck somewhere? Oh. That posse's coming. What are we sharpening? Can I talk to this thing? Look out! It's a rad scorpion! Click, click, clock. Can I help you with something? You're disrupting my experiments. I'd like to take one of your tests. How about my smarts?
And checkmate. Oh! It's a sore loser. Chitter. Kill plant. Click, click, click. You see a bemused man in a lab coat surrounded by laboratory equipment. There's an insane gleam in his eye. Scorpion appears to be wearing wire-rimmed glasses. It actually looks quite intelligent and non-threatening. But yet it wants to attack me. Just leave. He's running. Okay, so much for that. We be here to dance. Sore loser. Oh, look at that! Spectacles. A set of spectacles for eye correction. He also had a tool. Wait, didn't he run out? He's back in there. Who ran? Oh, it was when Myron that ran out then. Sorry. He's a sore loser. How? How could you kill my scorpion like that? I was close. So close. Yeah, try to make one who's not such a sore loser next time. But now we got spectacles. That's interesting. So now we need to go back and talk to... what's his name? Marcus. So where's Marcus again? Over here.
Something else you wanted?
Yeah, I have something I wanted to tell you.
Yeah? What?
About Chad.
Yeah? What?
Yeah? What? Chad kept about $1,000 from the last uranium shipment for himself. He's planning on bailing out of town. I got a briefcase of documents to prove it.
Well, in that case, we'd better be sure to stop him. Wanna come along?
Sure. Alright, Chad. Time to pay for your crimes. Oh, cool. I just gained 5 karma and 1,500 experience points. Myron is gaining some abilities. I've gone up a level. You found Chad guilty of skimming money from the caravans.
Something else you wanted? Yeah? What? Something else you wanted?
Do you want to travel with me?
There's too much going on right now. When things calm down, then I just might. Something else you wanted?
Sorry, it sounds like Morgan Freeman.
Got a little trouble with the mine. If you're interested in helping fix it, go talk to Zaius, the mine foreman.
Where can I find him?
Usually at the mine. Sometimes the saloon.
Anything else?
What exactly do you want? Okay. We got some folks missing. No idea what's happened. Find them. Get $500.
Huh. Should I take 500? Yeah, $500. Sounds good.
Great. Let me know when you found something, right?
Sure.
Something else you wanted?
People missing. Hmm. Alright.
Let's run over here and see what's going on. And I guess we'll call it an episode, right? You know what? I do want to buy some stuff if you actually have some money. Or sell some stuff. Rather. You don't have much money. Close enough. I drew a blank for a second. All right. We have to level. Oh, this looks like something I can click on. Patrol, patrol, patrol. All I ever do around here. Alright, picking a perk. Bonus move. For each level of bonus move, you get 2 free APs each turn that can only be used for movement. Could help us get away. Cautious nature. +3 to your perception in random encounters when determining placement. 50% more skill points when reading books. +5 to your armor class, in addition to the AC bonus from any armor worn. That looks good. Sequence +2. +2 skill points when you... The mark of the explorer. Greater chance of finding special places and people. Faster healing. Healer. I can carry more stuff. Immediately gain 1 experience level. Oh my. Pleasing sexually. Your karma shines twice as bright. Your karma is doubled for any kind of reaction or modifiers. 1 extra slot in your companion limit. More than 5 is always a crowd. What if that includes the player character? One of your traits is mutated into something else. You have gained the attention of a mysterious stranger who will appear to help you from time to time. If your ally is lost in combat, then expect him or her to be replaced. Oh, what's that about? Reduce overall darkness level by 20%. You need to carry more stuff. Reaction 10% per level. Quick pockets. You get into your inventory with less AP. Quicker recover from being knocked down. Better able to avoid radiation. Radiation resistance 15%. 15% towards outdoorsmen. Increase the size of exploration as a world map by 1 map square every direction. There's a lot of these. Sharpshooter. It's easier than ever to kill at long range. Sounds good too. Intelligence by 1 up to 10 for purposes of dialogue only. 25% to poison resistance. Less likely to be knocked down in combat. It looks like the thing. It looks a lot like the thing from Fantastic Four. Additional 50 pounds of equipment. Yeah, +5 bonus when you get experience points. One-time bonus of +10% to your sneak, lockpick skill, and traps. I'm gonna take dodge. Or dodger. Okay. So I have skill points. What do I want? I do want to increase science. 40%. Speech. These I think are good. Barter, gambling, outdoorsman. Traps is pretty horrible. We are leveled. Sure could use more help on the caravans. Find the missing people from Marcus. Divert more electrical power to Eric's home. Alright. Okay, so we'll help with Eric's home next. Longer episode, but hey. More funds. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.